What's up, guys? So today we're going to be doing a disassemble of the Night Owl Model DP8 DVR camera system. So basically what it does is it just records using cameras. This one is different since it sends out signals to like your phone, and it can basically let you watch your cameras through your phone. So I'm going to get the tools to take this apart in a second. While you do that, you guys can like and subscribe this video if you want to. Okay guys, got my tools now, so I am ready to start this project. So what we're going to do is we're going to unscrew these screws here, 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 and maybe some other ones that I haven't seen yet. So I'm going to do that right now. So I unscrewed the four screws, but I haven't unscrewed these four because that connects to some other parts that you see later in this video. But now I'm going to try to get off this plastic shell here to get into the internals. So I was able to get this off. So here it is. Putting this off. And it's quite simple. There's only a few components. But I'm going to give it a close-up of the components in a second. So now that is a little bit of a zoom. So now I can show you the components. So right here you see is a heat sink. That basically cools down some of the main parts like the CPU. This big piece of machinery right here is called a hard drive. It's basically what records all the information coming from the camera. So these things are just some ports to plug in the cameras, some HDMI, and some Ethernet cables, and maybe some USB, and there's also the power supply cable right here. So all I have to do is just disconnect these SATA cable or SATA connectors, and if I can pull this off, this connector that connects the SATA cable to the rest of the motherboard. So now that is off. Now I can take off the hard drive, which is just these four screws here that I mentioned earlier. So all I have to do is just unscrew these screws, and I'll be back with you in a second. So I have one more screw right here left. All I do have to do is just unscrew it. Should I be careful with this hard drive here? So it doesn't fall out. And there we go. We have this hard drive right here. So 1 terabyte camera system hard drive, or DVR hard drive. It's pretty simple, quite small, but does some pretty good recording on this thing. So now that's all that's left is to remove these screws. And when it comes to this stuff, you kind of have to be careful because these are called capacitors and they can store up a lot of charge even when this is off. So if you're going to take apart anything, just be safe, and if you don't know what you're doing, don't try it at home. So I'm going to take off these screws right here, and I'll be back with you when that's done. So here's the last screw, and what I've noticed is that all the screws also act as a grounding, which is kind of weird. I never knew they can also serve that purpose. Well, let's just get this screw off really quick, and I can take off the motherboard. Now it's off. And I should be able to take off the motherboard, unless there's a hidden screw. In which there was, I didn't see that. Okay, so I'm going to take this screw off now. And now we should be able to take this off. A little bit of tinkering. Hold up, I'll be back. Okay, so I got it off. I did have to bend this plate here, but I did get it off. And I found the faulty part. This capacitor here blew up. So this thing broke during a thunderstorm, and some lightning struck the ground nearby. Went up through the house and damaged this thing. This thing still could be repairable, but overall, I don't think I could fix it. So, yeah. So I'm gonna set everything up and give you a summary of all the parts that I have and are included. Just be back when that happens. I also noticed that they did a sucky job at putting the thermal paste on, and it's kind of dried up on there, but I can just remove that with some alcohol. So guys, here's all the parts. The motherboard, which a part blew on that, so that's why it stopped working. Heatsink, some screws, some motherboard screws, the back plating and the bottom plate, the plastic cover. I knew this was plastic because of how it sounded. Like you even hear it's just plastic. The hard drive and the SATA connectors. So that's pretty much it. And I hope you like this video. So like and subscribe. And even hit that bell icon too, so you never miss one of my videos. Bye guys. Also guys, if we get to 50 likes, I will take apart that rug cleaner right there. So let's go guys.